So there are a lot of steps that are being taken to kind of slow down this coronavirus, including closing schools and college campuses.
With that in mind, Dr. Harry Kestler, he is a viral expert and microbiology professor at Lorain County Community College. He is here to talk about proactive measures that are being taken right now. Doctor, first of all, thank you so much for stopping in. Appreciate you.
Thank you for having me.
You sent us a couple of charts. I want to take a look at those charts right now, and if you could explain what we're looking at.
Okay.
That's not it.
Those aren't the charts. Yeah.
All right.
Oh, there you go.
Well, I can tell you that one there. This chart is describing the progression of the virus. The first one was about how long ago it hit in China, and then the number of deaths in China, and then the number of deaths in the rest of the world. And what you can see from the graphic is that China's leveling out, and the rest of the world is just beginning. In fact, newer data is even getting more intense.
Can I ask you a question real quick?
Yeah.
Why is China leveling out at this point?
China has been working really hard at with some social distancing, self-quarantining, all these kinds of things you're hearing about in the news.
But not exactly vaccines or anything.
There's no vaccine. There's
no
vaccine. The vaccine is about a year away, minimum. And I think we need one. But not for now. This is not going to, we're about to head into a storm right now.
So talk about the effect that it's had on people. Like, how many people do you think are affected in Ohio? We were talking, it gives us this false impression that, well, there's only 5 cases we're hearing about in Northeast Ohio, so I can get out and about and not worry.
What you're going to see, they saw this in China as well. What you're going to see is you're going to see a huge bump in the number of cases in the United States because we have not been testing yet. You know, you heard about the Cleveland Clinic developing a test. We are also doing the same at the college, and we're waiting on the test kits from the CDC to come through, and they're just starting to work into the area.
Why is it that a country like South Korea, 10,000 people being tested a day, and we are still behind the eight ball?
I'm not sure about that. Mm-hmm. That's a tough question to answer. Certainly, there's been a great test that the World Health Organization has been on top of this for the last month. If we were to get that test, I think we would have been a lot faster. I think we're a little slow. We kind of had our head stuck in the sand here. I do think that the governor is right on.
Okay.
What the governor is doing right now is justified. People are giving me a lot of grief. Nobody's going to tell you that, oh, you overreacted. They will give you grief if you, you know, years from now, if they said, boy, he didn't do enough.
Right.
So, I mean, I think that, yeah, you might say he's overreacting. You might say that that this is a bit too much. But I don't think so. I don't think you can level that criticism. If he didn't do enough, that'll be the real crime here.
You said something a couple of minutes ago that kind of got my attention. You said that we're heading into a storm. What do you mean by that?
We are heading into a storm. According to Dr. Acton from the state, and I agree with her, she thinks that we're looking at a tip of an iceberg with the 5 cases, that it's actually, this virus has seeded, you know, that it has seeded itself in the United States a couple weeks ago. So the cases that we're seeing, we're about to see a whole bunch more. What we want to do, and that's the second graphic that you saw earlier, is we want to flatten that curve. We're going into a storm, and you know, when you go into a storm in a boat, you want to face into the waves and not at the side, and you don't want to be tipped over. So we want to level the number of cases so that we don't have to open up high schools as hospitals.
Right. Do you think that the warmer weather is going to help flatten that line a little bit?
I think that one of the things that, you know, social distancing, let me just hold your hand out. You know, we're not quite there. There we are.
Is that good enough?
That's about 6 feet. That's a good distance.
Yeah. And that's
six
everybody.
Feet is good.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's hard to do that with everybody inside.
Yeah.
When we all go outside, and we all do, it's very easy to maintain that distance. It's very easy to maintain. Indoor venues especially are problematic because, you know, there's issues. And sneezing, you know, if you've got people coughing and sneezing. My wife works for Cleveland Schools, and, you know, she basically takes a sneeze bath every day from her
sneeze
students.
Sneeze bath.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this. How long do you think this is going to last? I mean, China's, you know, they're getting out of it. How long do you think it's going to be here?
If you look at where we are and where China was, we're about a month out. we are about 1 month away from actually what I hope is the end. Now, it could be a good month or a bad month. It might be a little longer. If we're successful, it'll be longer, actually, to tell you the honest to God truth. Because we will have, what we want to do is keep the hospitals at capacity, not over. Because then people get hurt.
Right.
When we don't have enough health care, when we don't have the health care capacity, people get hurt.
We have to wrap this up, but in one sentence, what are you most scared of with COVID-19?
I think the thing that is people. I think we all need to be good to each other. There's a lot of things that we can do for each other to help us help each other out. Be creative about being good to your fellow humans. Mm-hmm. Make accommodations for people who are struggling. There are people struggling, but I think at heart, we Americans are all good people.
Yep.
And we need to be good to each other and help each other out through this.
Dr. Kestler, we'll thank you. Thank you so much
thank
for your time.
You.
Good information
Appreciate
for us.
It.
Appreciate you, sir.
All right, more Fox 8 when we come back.